Right, so we are ready to go back to Tableau and perform a few additional operations with the table we created earlier. Right now, it shows us the number of units sold by the firm in each month of 2016 and 2017. Let's change this measure. What I would like it to show us is the revenue the company generated during each of these periods. How can I do that? Well, it's fairly easy. Our source data contains information about price, and Tableau counted the number of units sold. Each row shows us a single car sale, right? Therefore, if we multiply the price field and the auto-generated number of records field, we would obtain revenues. Do you agree? Okay, good. Let's do that. We already know how to create a calculated field. I'll name it Revenue, and we'll take advantage of Tableau's autocomplete suggestions by multiplying price and number of records. See? As we said in our previous lesson, we can use the star operator to carry out a multiplication. One very useful feature, you have probably noticed, is that at the bottom of the screen, Tableau tells us whether the calculation we've entered is a valid one or not. Right now, my calculation is valid. If I remove a few symbols, Tableau would indicate that the calculation contains errors. This is a good guiding light when we create a calculation. Right, so this is our revenue field. We can easily substitute the number of records data in the table with it. All I have to do is drag the revenue field and position it over the number of records data. Tableau replaces the two fields. Perfect! An important metric contained in our source data is gross profit. By definition, revenue minus COGS equals gross profit. Currently, we have revenue and gross profit. Let's calculate COGS as the difference between the two. That's easy to do. All we have to do is use the minus operator. Nice. Let's order our table in the following way. First, we'll have revenue, then COGS, and finally, gross profit. I can do that by dragging and dropping the three fields within the table. Please note that their values appear in the Measure Values card on the left side of the workspace area. We can change their order either from here or directly inside the table. It's up to you. One more thing. You have probably noticed the Measure Names field, which appeared in the Columns section. This is an auto-generated field Tableau uses in order to form our table and separate the names of different measures. If we were to remove it from the Columns section, the table will lose its shape, and all three measures will be put together. Let's press Ctrl and Z and undo this action. Okay, excellent. In our next lesson, we'll learn how to add totals and subtotals to our tables in Tableau. This will do for now. Thanks for watching.